Welcome to another Audible article from MindPower, CenterPoint's free weekly email newsletter. Every Monday, MindPower brings you inspirational articles from leaders in the personal development field, useful tips and techniques to improve your life, plus CenterPoint news and updates. See the links below for more information about this week's MindPower. This week's article is Values and Visions, How to Activate Your Vision Board, written and read by Marc Gilson. When Rhonda Byrne first published her landmark book, The Secret, back in 2006, millions of people were introduced to the idea that thoughts are things, that the power of your mind shapes everything you do, feel, and experience, and that you tend to attract what you focus on. It also introduced people to vision boards. A documentary-style movie based on the book was then released, featuring many luminaries in the personal development field, including CenterPoint's late founder, Bill Harris. The Secret defined the concept of translating your thoughts into tangible results and using your mind to attract success and happiness. And at the center of it all was the vision board. With the almost overnight success of The Secret, it seemed like everybody was making their own vision boards and then waiting for the magic to happen. Now, if you're new to vision boards, the concept is simple. Just find yourself a cork board or a wooden panel. Cut out or print some images that reflect your goals and dreams and then pin them up on your vision board. The idea is to give your brain something visually inspiring to focus on that represents your goals and aspirations, a kind of collage of your hopes and dreams. But not everyone saw positive results from their vision boards. While people pinned up photos of fancy cars, beautiful houses, fit bodies, exotic locales, and piles of cash, the truth is that few people saw those pictures turn into reality. In fact, for some people, seeing those photos of how their lives could be while living a very different life was more a source of frustration and disappointment rather than inspiration. After all, it can be disheartening to wake up each day to a constant reminder of the life you want versus the one you're living. So, it's no surprise that some vision boards ended up ripped down and shoved into a closet or tossed in the trash. And that's too bad, because when used properly, vision boards can be a great tool for achieving your desired outcomes. So then, why do vision boards seem to work for some people, but not for others? Some would tell you that it's because the laws about attraction and talk of thoughts as things is just hooey and nonsense. Others would say that some people just have more powerful minds or are more responsive to visual images. Maybe we're just not using the right imagery. Maybe we don't have enough faith in the whole idea or in ourselves. But the truth is, vision boards don't do much unless you know how to activate them. When there's a disconnect between your visions and your reality, it's not because your brain isn't powerful enough. It's because you haven't activated the vision. You haven't turned your vision board on. Like an unplugged TV or computer, vision boards need to be plugged in and powered up to work. We've all heard the old saying, a picture is worth a thousand words. This is very true when it comes to a part of our minds that is often left out of the process of making a vision board. I'm talking about the unconscious. While we may consciously be quite aware of our goals and desires, we must also get the other half of our mind on board if we want to succeed. You see, just tacking up some pictures of nice things won't get the job done. We need the unconscious mind to help manifest our visions, or else it's like pedaling a bike with only one foot. And because the unconscious thinks in terms of imagery and symbols, the vision board only gets activated when the images we use are compelling to us on a very deep level. So, how do we get our unconscious mind to help us achieve what's on our vision board? To do that, we need to integrate our vision with our values. A CenterPoint client described his vision board to me this way. He said, "I spent hours on it, finding just the right pictures. Not just a sports car, but a very specific make, model, year, and color. Not just a nice house, but a house designed in a specific architectural style. Not just lots of money, but a specific amount, down to the dollar." Now, he went on to say that despite the effort he'd put into his vision board, nothing much happened. "It just doesn't work for me," he said. But rather than abandoning the idea of a vision board, we explored his values together. This process, called values clarification, can be extremely powerful. It unlocks the doorways to the depths of our own motivation, and you guessed it, it gives us a peek into the unconscious mind. Values, those things we deem are most deeply important to us, are rarely reflected on most vision boards. That's because vision boards are made by the conscious mind. Now, your conscious mind is pretty smart, to be sure. It has no trouble finding images of impressive wealth, prestige, or success. But what if we're missing something important? What if our vision board doesn't really align with our values? Getting back to my client, we picked one image from his vision board to explore from the perspective of values. We chose a picture of a pile of cash. Pictures of money are common features on vision boards, but few people really take the time to consider what money means to them. What does money represent on a values level? What's money really mean? My client discovered that money equated to values like freedom, peace of mind, and his desire to help others. So, along with that enticing stack of cash, my client also found new images that reflected these values, values he held at a very deep level. He had uncovered his values around money, plugged in his unconscious desires, and activated his vision board. He said, "I looked at it and just knew that it was right. It felt right. It felt like me." As we walked through each image, refocusing on the deeper values behind them, his new vision board began to emerge. And as he continued to work toward his desired outcomes, more and more of the images from his vision board materialized in his life, like 2D static images that came to life. Is this magic? Well, in a way, yes. It's a way to tap into the magic of your values and the power of your mind to create the life you dream about. So, now that you know how to activate your vision board, maybe it's time to pull it out of the closet, dust it off, and see what happens when you dig into the values behind each image. If you do, I know you'll rediscover one of the best tools there is for manifesting your dreams. Hey, you want to learn more about how your vision is powered by your values? Well, we've got the perfect masterclass for you. It's called Master Your Life, and it comes with unlimited coaching, so you can even talk through your values and your vision with one of our accelerated results coaches. You can learn more in the description below. Thanks for listening. If you enjoyed this article, please like, subscribe, and share. Until next time, be well.